Hi, we are going to learn a programming technique that has changed the world of programming to a substantial extent. This technique has reduced stress of many software developers and it has improved their lives. This technique is going to help you, the software developers, to build better softwares quickly. What is this technique? Welcome to object-oriented programming. What is this? This is just a way of programming in which you will be using objects. What are objects then? Let's go to a nearby farm and we will see a few objects. Now we are going to go. This farm can be called as an object. ಏನಿದೆಪ್ಪ ಈ ತೋಟದಲ್ಲಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅರೆಕನಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ತೆಂಗಿನ ಮರ ಇದೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಾಳೆಗಿಡ ಇದೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ದೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ತೋಟ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತದಪ್ಪ ಬೆಳೆ ಬೆಳೀತದೆ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ ಆಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಇದೆ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ ಕೂಡ ಇದೆ ನಾವೊಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಗಿಡ ನೋಡು ಇದು ಸೂಜಿ ಮೆಣಸಿನ ಗಿಡ ಈ ಸೂಜಿ ಮೆಣಸಿನ ಗಿಡ ಇದನ್ನೊಂದು ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ತಗೊಳ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಸೂಜಿ ಮೆಣಸಿದು ಗಿಡದ ಬರೀ ಒಂದು ಎಲೆಯನ್ನೇ ಒಂದು ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೋದು ಮೆಣಸನ್ನು ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೋದು ಸೂಜಿ ಮೆಣಸಿನ ಗಿಡವನ್ನು ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಜೀರಿಗೆ ಮುಂಚಿ ಅಥವಾ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸೈ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ ಕೂಡ ಕರೀತೇವೆ ಅಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಚಿಟ್ಟೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಚಿಟ್ಟೆಯನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ತಕೊಳ್ಬೋದು ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಆಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ಸ್ ಕಲರ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ವಿಡ್ತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಆಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಫ್ಲೈ ಸಿಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪಾಂಡ್ ವಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ವಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಅನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ತಕೊಳ್ಬೋದು ಅದರ ಕಲರ್ ಬಣ್ಣ ಅದು ಅದರದ್ದೊಂದು ಆಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಅದು ಅರಳ್ತದೆ ಮುದುಡ್ತದೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಅದರ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಇದರದ್ದು ಕಲರ್ ಬೇರೆ ಇದರದ್ದು ರೀತಿ ಬೇರೆ ಇದೊಂದು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ತಗೊಳ್ಬೋದು ಇದು ಮುಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಮುನಿ ಟಚ್ ಮೀ ನಾಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಎಲೆಯ ಒಳಗಡೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಎಲೆ ಇದೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಲೆ ಇದೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಸಬ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಆಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಲೆಂತ್ ವೆಯ್ಟ್ ಕಲರು ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಕಲರು ಲೀಫ್ ಕಲರ್ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಅದರದ್ದು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಆಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಎಲೆಯನ್ನು ಮುಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಎಲೆ ಮಡಿಸ್ತದೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನ್ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟಚ್ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಟ್ವಿಗ್ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಟ್ವಿಗ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾಲ್ ಡೌನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅನದರ್ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ ನಾವು ತೋಟಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿ ತುಂಬ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ಬಂದೆವು ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆನ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ಆರ್ ಟಚ್ ಆರ್ ಇವನ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೂ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸೀ ವಿತ್ ಒನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ This is a pen object. This pen has a body color. This is an attribute. Ink color, another attribute. Length, weight, price of the pen, all these can be attributes. It has certain behaviors. Pen by default has writing behavior. And also, clicking. This is a click pen. So you can click. So click is a behavior. The behaviors are known as methods. We have seen one object. How this object is going to be used in programming? Our concentration is on the technical representation. How technically we can use objects. But we will see one video where in which you have to visually identify objects. Yavudella objects kaanta ide identify maadi. Adralli en attributes irbodu, aa object ge yava attributes irbodu, yava behaviors irbodu. Attributes andre properties, behaviors andre methods. ಈ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಆ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ನೋಡುವ. You have seen a short video from good old game Call of Duty. In this tiny video, probably you have seen thousands of objects. Let's name few. Soldier, gun, stone, grass, plants, everything is an object. Let's name few attributes of soldier object. Soldier in every game has some health. Health, number of bullets, his height, his weight, his present state, whether he is running, walking, kneeling, all these are his states. And he has certain methods. He can shoot, he can run, all these are his methods. There can be many soldiers, that is, there can be many number of objects. So we have seen plenty of objects now, but how to use them in our program? For that, we have to understand classes. Objects has properties and methods. We will define objects using their properties and methods. You can have this concept generalized. The concept of object, for example, this pen is an object. What you will understand if I say pen, that concept can be a class. So concept of object is a class. So this class is acting as a template to create objects. We will see that. Now, let's create few classes in Java programming language. We will begin with an empty class. Empty class will not have any properties or methods. Let's see that. Here we have class definition of pen. We are going to create pen class. For simplicity, we will not add any properties or methods to this pen class, hence it is empty class. How to create that? We just need to write a keyword class followed by name of the class, that is pen. Class pen followed by open and close parenthesis. Open and close parenthesis contain body of the class. Here the body is empty. Here you are supposed to write properties and methods if you want. We have seen how to create a pen class. How to create any other class? We just need to follow the same syntax. How? It is like this. You just need to write class keyword followed by name of the class and then body of the class within the parentheses. Flower parenthesis. Please remember, it is flower parenthesis.
We have created a class, but our intention is creating objects. How to create objects? It is also very simple. Here we have created pen objects. How it is? You just need to write name of the class, that is pen. Pen, my pen. This is name of the object. Pen, my pen is equal to new pen construction. I will read this sentence as new pen construction. Let's create another pen for you. That will be like pen, your pen is equal to new pen construction. How to create any other object? Object belonging to any other class or any class. It will be like this. You just need to write name of the class followed by name of the object is equal to new class construction. Here you need to replace with your class name. And this is called as constructor. We are going to learn more about this sooner. And if you want to pass anything while constructing the object, you can pass it here between the parentheses. Now we know how to create a class and how to create object of that class. Now let us revisit class definition and let's add few properties and methods to the class definition. So here we have the pen class back. Now we have added two properties, price and ink color. How to write properties? You have to declare the data type followed by the name of the property. Data type and name of the property. Here data type is int and name of the property is price. And the next, data type is string and name of the property is ink color. Similarly, you can add few methods. If you recall, pen has certain behaviors. One such behavior is writing. Writing is primary behavior. And if the pen is clicking pen, you can switch mode between writing mode and carry mode. For switching mode, let's add one method. This is switch mode method. To add a method, you need to write return type. What this method is going to return. What this method is going to give back. After the processing, what result this method is going to give back. For example, if you turn on the fan, you will get wind, blow of wind. And if you turn on the light, you will get that light, isn't it? Similarly, when you switch mode, what you are getting back? You are not actually getting anything back. Hence, the return type is void here. You are not going to get back anything. So this is method switch mode. Similarly, we can add other methods, write method. So write method is going to perform some writing operation. If you want to write, you need to have some text, isn't it? You will be passing, you can pass that text to this write method. What you want to write, that you can pass here as text. So that pass text, you need to add code for writing, that is here. Okay, so this is pen class with two attributes or two properties and two behaviors or two methods. So properties are price and color and the methods are switch mode and write. Now we have added the properties and methods. Now we need to access those things. How we can access? First, we need to create an object. Now we have created objects, two objects actually, my pen and your pen. Let's demonstrate accessing the members. Members are either properties or methods. Now let's demonstrate how to access these members using the dot operator. To access members of the object, we will be using dot operator. Now we have my pen object. This is an object of pen class. Hence it will have all the members of pen class. Now we can access mypen.price. mypen.price will either return the price or it will set the price. Here we have put equal to 20. Now the price will be set to 20. Price of the mypen object will be set to 20. Similarly, you can invoke the methods. How to invoke the methods? You just need to use the dot operator once again. mypen.switchMode. SwitchMode method is not going to receive any arguments, hence the empty parenthesis. mypen.switchMode. This will invoke SwitchMode method. Similarly, I can also invoke write method. But the write method will receive one text argument. Hence, you need to pass that text. What to write? mypen.writeHi. So, this method is invoked with the argument hi. So, now we have created class. Then we have created object. We have added few properties and methods. And we have invoked those properties and methods. Now, once again, let's go back to the class definition. So this is class definition of pen class. Here we have certain properties and methods. You can see we have combined properties and methods as one unit inside a class. We have combined properties and methods as a unit inside one class. This feature of object-oriented programming language is called as encapsulation. Encapsulation is nothing but combining the data and associated functionality. What are the data? Data is nothing but the properties. And associated functionality, they are the methods. If you combine them together, that will become one capsule containing both property and method, which will be a class. Instance of that will be an object. So this feature is called as encapsulation. Let's see another feature. You may recall this picture. This is a photo of bird's eye chili plant. So this object is consisting of a stem, leaves, flowers and buds and the tiny chilies. The bird's eye chili plant is composed of several other objects. Similarly, this plant is also composed of stem, leaves, and tiny other flowers and buds. This capability is called as composition. What is composition? An object can contain other objects. For example, a car can contain several other objects such as engine, wheels, seats, so on. Let's see one example. In Java, we have pen class. This consisted few properties such as price and ink color. But actually, a pen is going to contain refill, spring and body if it is a click pen. So these refill, spring and body, they belong to some other class. These are objects of some other class. So this is a composition. In Java, string is also a class. Hence, ink color is also an object of class string. Hence, all these four are objects of other classes. So pen object will be composed of these four other objects. So this is composition in Java. Let's see one smaller example. Here we have class X and class Y. The class Z is formed using two properties, X, object X, and object Y. So here object X and object Y are objects of class X and Y. Hence class Z is composed of class X and Y. Another interesting capability of an object-oriented programming language is inheritance. Inheritance is the capability of extending the existing. You may have certain classes in your repository, you can use those classes to create new classes. The newer classes will contain the members of the existing classes if you inherit the new class from the existing class. Let's see it. So this is how you can extend the classes. You just need to have a class. This class is called B, is containing an integer member B. We are going to create a new class, class C. This class C is extended from the existing class B. This class C is going to contain a member C. Class C is containing the member C, but this will also contain member B, which is inherited from the existing class B. So how do you inherit a class? Using extends keyword. We will just reorganize the code. Class B with the member B, class C with the member C. We can create class C object in this way, new C construction. After the C object, this OBJ is created, you can access the members, individual members such as obj.c. This will be member of class C. obj.b is member of class B. Let's recall what we have learned. Nanatra nai maride to tinku. Tinku yenu idondu object. Tinku yava classic sertade, dog classic sertade. Ivrella yaru? Ivrella instances of the class dog. We have learned what is an object. Object can be anything that you can see, touch, or imagine. Every object will contain properties and methods. Properties are any associated data of an object. Behavior or the methods are the capability of an object. Examples for properties. If you recall pen, body color, ink color, price, these can be possible attributes for a pen. You don't need to have the real attributes when you program. You can use your own attributes. Similarly, you can add methods in your Java classes. And the concept behind one object is called as a class. This class will compose the properties and the methods. It will combine properties and methods, and this feature of object-oriented programming language is known as encapsulation. You can create objects using many other objects. This capability is known as composition. One another interesting ability of an object-oriented language is inheritance. Here, you can use an existing class to create a new class. Now, it is time for an activity. Mosquito hunt is a game. In this game, you have to observe and identify objects, their classes, and associated properties and methods. You need to create Java classes for each of those. Let's begin. In mosquito hunt, you need to protect this baby. This baby will be laughing. If a mosquito bites him, he will be crying. You should never let the baby to cry. To protect this baby, you will be having a mosquito missile. This mosquito missile have certain range limitations. This is range begin and this is range end. This and this are range end. Missile cannot attack a mosquito behind this range. Similarly, missile cannot attack a mosquito which is after this. Now, if a mosquito comes, you can fire the missile. Let's see what happens. There is a mosquito. Let's fire the missile. The mosquito will be killed. If you don't fire the missile in time, the mosquito is going to bite the baby. Now you need to do the activity. You have to identify at least three objects from mosquito hunt game. You need to determine their classes. Then list possible properties and methods. Then you'll be creating Java classes at least with the two properties and two methods. You can explore more using these references. These are some good references. And you have two bonus videos. One video will describe how to create an object-oriented system. And the other video will explore the object-oriented pillars, the important concepts behind object-oriented programming language in depth. Thank you for watching. Take care and happy learning.